Welcome to our first presentation of the campaign mode in the Riftbreaker. We join Ashley and Mr. Riggs on day 12 of their mission on Galatea 37. Their current objective is to find titanium necessary to build the Rift Station, a way to open up a portal back to Earth. They are on their way to the volcanic region of the planet. Luckily, we don't have to go there on foot. We can use the planet scanner, a powerful tool that pinpoints the right locations for rift jumps over long distances. Over the course of the campaign in the Riftbreaker, you will need to explore various regions of the alien world you find yourself on. All of them are unique when it comes to fauna, flora, and environmental conditions. Each biome you visit poses a different set of challenges. Here, in the volcanic region, the ambient temperature is really high. That results in Mr. Riggs taking damage to his armor. That is why using repair kits and finding places where we can shelter ourselves from the heat will be very important here. Well, we managed to find the first aggressive creatures in this biome. Naturally, because they live in a volcanic region, they are resistant to fire. We will have to use some other tricks in order to deal with them. The basic weaponry that the Riftbreaker possesses at the moment will not do much against the power of this stone giant. We should teleport back to the base and work on getting some better equipment. The research tree in the Riftbreaker contains lots of useful blueprints and technologies that we can use to gain advantage over the native creatures and to brave the difficult conditions of various regions of Galatea 37. As you progress in the game, you will unlock more and more powerful options. Advanced explosive weapons sound good in our situation. Let's do some work around the base while we wait for the blueprints to download. You never know what to really expect in the Riftbreaker, so setting up additional defensive towers in some downtime is always a good idea. Alright, the blueprints for the advanced rocket launcher arrived, but we have a slight problem. In order to craft this weapon, we require 300 pieces of enriched uranium. We don't have it on hand. Luckily, we know where to find uranium in the wild. Let's go to the radioactive desert now. We need to set up a mining outpost in this area. We have a lot of resources available already. Our headquarters keeps producing resources even though we are not there. Of course, that doesn't mean that we shouldn't look for the best spot possible. Every resource deposit that we manage to make use of will boost our economy and bring us one step closer towards reaching our goal. This is a good spot for a mining outpost. We have uranium ore at the ready, and there is also a carbonium deposit that we can use to boost our economy. However, basics first. We need to supply this outpost with power. Solar panels should do the job. Solar activity in this desert is very high, which makes solar panels very effective. Thanks to that, we can set up a functional, self-sufficient base in no time. Now, we can set up uranium mines to dig up uranium ore from the ground. Crude uranium won't be useful for us though. We still need to set up uranium centrifuges in order to enrich it. Only after that we will gain access to enriched uranium that we can use in production of our weapons and other buildings. Unfortunately, the creatures inhabiting this desert are not happy with us interfering with their peace and quiet. Even worse, they are resistant to physical attacks from our basic sentinel towers. We are going to need better protection. Let's repair the damage done and come up with a better solution. We could use plasma towers, for example. They deal a lot of energy damage very quickly, but require palladium, and we don't have any palladium available right now. We do have a palladium mining outpost set up already. We need to go there and find out what's wrong and why we are not getting any resources from it. This is where the problem came from. The pipe leading from the sludge pool to the gas filtering plant was broken. Because of that, this facility couldn't provide our gas power plants with the flammable gas that they used for fuel. Once we fix that issue, our factories should come back online and we are going to get a steady stream of palladium that we require to build our plasma towers. In the Riftbreaker, all your bases that you set up during one playthrough remain operational as long as all their energy and resource consumption requirements are met. Okay, our towers are back online, and it seems that our factories are working again. We can now leave this place and go back to our new desert outpost. The factories will transport palladium straight to our global storage, and we can use it anywhere we like. After replacing these basic sentinel towers with more powerful plasma ones, we should be safe from the attacks of the creatures that inhabit this desert. That took some time, but the work is done. Now let's find a test subject to test the efficiency of our new towers. Works like a charm. Now we can easily defend our uranium mining outpost and our uranium centrifuges. Thanks to all the hard work that we've been doing, we now have enough uranium to craft an advanced rocket launcher. Let's equip it now. This advanced model of the rocket launcher features a mod slot where we can equip additional modules that change the properties of the weapon. Let's see how our rocket launcher behaves when we install a homing projectiles mod. This will definitely make aiming much easier. Our mining operation seems to have triggered an entire horde of angry enemy creatures to attack our base. This is a great chance to test our new equipment and fight against these enemy creatures. The new weapons definitely passed the test. With the help of these rocket launchers, artillery towers and plasma towers, this outpost will definitely survive on its own. We can now go back to our headquarters and start planning for exploration of the volcanic region again. Using the uranium that we gathered in our desert outpost, we can construct the fusion field accelerator. It's a module of our rift station, the building that will eventually take us back home. We are one step closer to completing our mission, but we still need that titanium. Volcanic area, here we come! In order to complete your mission on Galatea 37, you will need to set up a global network of bases, all working together towards reaching your goal, opening the portal back home. That will give you a chance to visit a multitude of fascinating places. All maps in the Riftbreaker are procedurally generated from specially crafted world components. No two playthroughs will ever be the same as you decide on the order of your priorities. The Riftbreaker is coming this autumn to PC, Xbox Series X, Series S, and PlayStation 5.